Ma'am, I've stopped.
Okay.
Ma'am, now Akash is recording.
Okay, Akash, now do it. Chalo. Let me know when it begins.
Yes, ma'am, I've started.
Okay. So, good morning, class. Now, today we will take up the new poem, Indian by Sarojini Naidu. Okay? Indian writer. She is the Indian author. She writes the poem and lovely stories also. And she was at the time when India was about to attain independence in 1947. It was during that time when she was there and she wrote the poems based on her experiences. Okay, so now I'll quickly read out the poem for you. Weavers weaving at break of day, why do you weave a garment so gay? Blue as the wing of a helican bird, wild, we weave the robes of a newborn child. The second paragraph. Weavers weaving at fall of night, why do you weave a garment so bright? Like the plumes of a peacock purple and green, we weave the marriage veils of a queen. Third paragraph. Weavers weaving solemn still, what do you weave in the moonlight chill? White as a feather and white as a cloud, we weave a dead man's funeral shroud. So before we go on to the line-wise explanation, let me just quickly tell you what the poem is talking about. The summary of the poem, though the summary doesn't come in the exam, but you need to know the crux, the central idea of the poem. Now here, Sarojini Naidu has very beautifully and descriptively described the three stages of a human being. First is the child. When a newborn child is born, his life is full of excitement. He's ready to give that energy to everyone. He's full of energy. The young baby is full of energy. And so at that time, the weavers which are weaving, the color of their the garment that they're weaving is, it is bright. It is like of a hellion bird. A hellion bird is a very energetic bird. It's found in tropical Asia. Kingfisher it is. And in Hindi, we call it Neelkanth. So here, the hellion bird has described the chirpy, the bubbling infant or a child born is compared with a hellion bird, which is full of life and energy. Then in the second paragraph, they talk of the second stage of human life, and that is the adulthood. That means a mature man, a mature person, who has attained maturity, who has attained youth, and is all in all full of life. It is telling the experience also. So a daybreak is a time when you are very full of energy. And that daybreak has been compared with a newborn child. Then in the second paragraph, you talk of a night. That means the night time is full of darkness. That means the whole day has been spent. So this talks of the adulthood or the age when you are just maturing enough, you're turning into gaining a lot of experience through age. Okay. And then third stage they talk of the moonlight chill. That means the chilling moonlight, the white spread darkness of moonlight. Now, then it is the old age which has been compared here, and the old age has been told as if it is the time that all the life has been lived. I'm sorry for this noise. It is on the road. I'm sorry. Can you still hear me? Just say yes, one of you.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I'll try to be a little louder. They are doing some work on the road. I'm sorry. So this last phase talks about the old age and when the man has lived up his life. So here the moonlight is, the whiteness of the moonlight, the chillingness of the moonlight is compared with the old age. And it is that time of the night when the weaver is weaving a funeral shroud. Now, what is the shroud? It is the cloth which is used for covering up a dead body. Okay. So now this is the summary of the poem. And The line-wise explanation, I'm also sending you along with this. Please go through it right now. I end the class right now. Children, you just, Akashi, please switch off.